University Talk here on the Talk Station, FM 107 AM 1240. Let me go right away to the, this is the 1 year anniversary special of the University Talk Sports Block, and I'm going to go right away to Mikey. How's it going, sir? Hold up. Manny's actually going to bring you up. Go ahead, Mike.
It's going spectacular. I can't believe it's been a year of the Utah Sports Block.
Unbelievable. Joe, are you standing by with us?
Oh, I'm with you, man.
Listen,
I'm fine.
I said at the beginning of the show, you guys, when I go out and we do some of these events and stuff out in town, and we meet people that even remotely even know what I'm involved with the University Talk program, they say, oh, that sports segment's great. I'm like, okay. You listen to the last 15 minutes of the show? That's it? I mean, come on. Tell me something about me. But anyway, so you guys are getting rave reviews out there. And I would like to actually take a trip down memory lane, so to speak. So what we're going to do right now is actually throw back to some of the more fun moments that we've had here on the University Talk program on the UTalk Sports Block. So guys, sit tight, and here it comes.
But we're going to be getting into a subject here in a few minutes, a new program, new segments on sports.
Mm-hmm.
I'm looking forward to this. We're going to meet who?
We're going to meet Mikey and Joe on the UTalk Sports Block, and this is a new segment we're going to try out here on UTalk.
Management has no idea what to expect.
No, we have not. We've neglected to let management know anything about this.
It's time for the UTalk Sports Block. With your hosts, Mikey and Joe!
Holy cow. Mikey, Joe, you guys are standing by, am I right?
Yes, you are.
Oh, you are right.
Joe, you're there. Hey, what's going on in the world of college sports these days?
A lot.
When I saw that Sean May had been basically dropped from the team because he's out of condition, that was embarrassing.
That is an embarrassment. That's an embarrassment to the whole organization and specifically to Sean May. I mean, he should be humiliated. Back in school. Hello, Joseph.
Hello, Michael. How are you?
I'm good. Any gig that I don't have to wear pants for is a good gig for me, so I'm in a great mood.
Of course you are. You know what? You know who else is in a great mood?
Who?
College basketball fans, because the season has begun.
Oh, the season has indeed begun, and I'll tell you who's in a really good mood. Fans of the University of North Carolina Tar Heels. We just sit around talking about you. I mean, look at this. You got Villanova, Connecticut, Marquette, Pittsburgh, Syracuse, Georgetown, Notre Dame, Louisville. I mean, I just named a bunch of teams that could be Final Four competitors right there. Just rolled off my tongue.
I think we lost Mikey and Joe in the midst of that. Gentlemen, are either of you with me right now? Well, that's all right. We'll get back to some of this discussion about what's going on in the world of sports in just a second. Here we are with Mikey and Joe back on the Utah Sports Block. Gentlemen, there's no reason to hang up. I mean, there's still more show to go.
I did not hang up. I believe I was hung up on. Am I not allowed to say the Tower Hillsborough might not be the best?
That might have had something to do with it. I don't know.
I think that was it. As soon as I mentioned Duke, the connection went off.
Connection goes out. I'm sorry we insulted the Heelys. I mean, my goodness gracious. But anyway,
I believe we don't have to talk about Duke, but I figured we should.
Yeah, I mean, we'll never mention that. They will be they who shall not be named from now on.
We tied up the Duke fan that ran in here and hung up on you guys, so you're good to go.
Well, thank you, Vince. Talk about the Big East now. That seems safe, right, Jeff?
Yeah, I don't want to hang up on us again. So we'll just say Duke's number 9, and they have also a good shot to be in the Final Four, but that's it for tonight.
But that's it. We're done. We got to stop. We got to move on. We're going to get right in. I'm afraid they're going to have people outside my house.
You probably do already.
I'm looking out the window already.
What's going on with Plexico Burris?
All right. Well, Mr. Burris, and I heard you guys were just, you know, before this segment, we're talking about colleges and loans. Mr. Burris went to a university, I'm sure you all heard of, Michigan State University. I'm not sure he got the education he needed.
It's an accredited university.
It is.
Obviously, the gun safety class, he must have skipped that one.
He was in a nightclub in New York City last Friday night, and he brought a gun for protection, and he brought it in. He was wearing sweatpants.
To me, before we go on, that's really the thing we need to look at here. All right, we know that there is a scary culture of athletes getting mugged and bringing guns, and it's a terrible thing. What about this sweatpants subculture now? First of all, who wears sweatpants to a club? And second of all, if you're going to carry a gun, Sweatpants, not exactly the best holster. They're a little loose by definition. Maybe a belt.
Right.
Khakis, perhaps.
Wouldn't it be sort of obvious that you had a gun in your pocket if you were wearing sweatpants?
Well, yeah, I would think.
That's why I don't, you know, wear sweatpants when I go out.
Well, yeah, because, what, are you carrying a gun, Joe?
That's not for now.
All right, we'll discuss that one in a later day. I guess I'm the Antonio Pierce here.
I guess you are. Plus, you know, he just signed a new contract for $35 million. You think he can afford a pair of nice pants?
Yeah, with a belt. With a tighter pair of sweats. Because what happened is, as he was walking towards the VIP lounge, probably looking all cool, the gun started to slip down his sweat pants.
Rewind the tape.
He reached into his sweatpants to get the gun that was falling down, and he accidentally shot himself in the thigh.
We have the people at the club who have a metal detector, and clearly either it didn't go off or they didn't mind that he had a gun.
Well, it was Giants receivers get in free with gun knife.
All right. And we're back on UTalk on the Talk Station, FM 107, AM 1240. Congratulations to Tony Murray from Newport, who won our tickets to the Velveteen Rabbit opening tomorrow in Carmike Cinemas in the area. So congratulations to him. He'll be able to get those tickets soon. And joining us now for the UTalk Sports Block, we're running somewhat of an abbreviated edition given our fascination with college textbooks today. Welcoming Mikey and Joe back to the program once again. Thank you guys for joining us.
Hey, how are you? How's it going, Vince? Calling shenanigans. I think we were actually the first callers in the Velveteen Rabbit tickets are ours.
Yeah, we've been waiting here for at least 10 minutes, so the Rabbit tickets belong to us.
Yeah, they're ours.
We also have standing by Mike and Joe. We're going to be talking to them about sports. But first, since we're talking about college education, Mike, Joe, I'm sure you're going to be fascinated about this. Tell us about the fine sport of World of Warcraft. Vince, what are you doing in California?
Hey, Lachlan, how's it going? I'm coming to you live from Anaheim, California, the site of this year's BlizzCon, which stands for Blizzard Convention. You know, we're out here and checking out the crowd. There are a lot of nerds here.
All right, speaking of nerds, oh, no, I shouldn't do that. Mike and Joe, let's get them on. Mike, Joe, hey, what's going to happen to sports with all these people that are focused on toggles and digits and TVs?
Something tells me we're going to get by just fine without them.
Yeah, I don't feel as though the people out at the World of Warcraft conference right now are athletes, so I'm not too worried about it.
A whole new athletic endeavor. All right, I got to go to you, Eric.
Yeah.
Hey, go ahead.
I gotta be honest. People of my stunning physique are, I'm certainly in the minority here, but we're looking around. We're finding them.
Stunning physique. Eric, you know what he looks like, too. All right.
Guys, welcome back to the show. Joe, how's it going, man?
Vince, going great. How about you?
I'm doing just fine, sir. And Mike, hi.
I'm doing fantastic.
I think what I'll do from now on is say, hey, Joe, how's it going? And then I'll say, hey, Mike. And he'll be like, doing great. Thanks for asking. How's that?
I think it's a good shtick. I think we're a regular Abbott and Costello here, Vince.
We could do that. It's really sad that I mentioned it live, though. We should have done this off the air. Oh, well.
The Utah Comedy Block tonight.
The Utah Comedy Block.
Absolutely.
Well, thank you, gentlemen. That wraps up the inaugural section of, and I'd like for you guys to stand by. Stick around on the phone, because I got to talk to you guys off the air. I have a feeling that this is going to continue into the weeks ahead. And that was the Sports Block. What do you think, Lockwood? Do you think, you never heard of these guys?
Yeah. I haven't heard them, and in spite of the fact that they've got an obvious brogue, that is a Yankee accent. That's good. I like that.
Oh, wow. It's like that drug trip I saw in that movie when I was on that drug trip.